The following program contains scenes of violence and mature subject matter. Viewer discretion is advised.
Wrestling fans, welcome back to another action-packed edition of Monster Pro Wrestling's Monday Night Dynamite here on Shaw Television. We're going to start us off tonight with a tag match. In one corner, we're going to have Steve Rivers and Bradley Graham, the sexy American superstars, going up against the mysterious, the devious, the somewhat kind of evil Weapons of Mass Seduction. Let's go to the tape.
Weapons of Mass Seduction. Well, you know what? You're looking at two big weapons right here. You don't know what you're in for. Two huge weapons of mass destruction. And there's something you don't have. Sexiness. Tell them, Bradley.
I am the big sexy beast. And that is one thing you guys will not ever achieve, is that status.
Pure sexiness.
We have the Weapons of Mass Seduction. Now, I'll tell you, there's not a lot known about these guys. I've seen one, I've seen two, I've seen three of them. They come from under the ring, they come from the rafters. You just don't know about these guys.
The fans love them, and I'll be honest, I don't know why. One of them's a little more rotund than the other two, don't you think? I really don't want to check out how rotund they are right now at this point. They're just, I think these guys, I call them Nova 1, 2, and 3, because I can't really point them apart that well. I'm not sure how an official allows two in a tag team and a third one running around once in a while. I mean, it's just ridiculous. Well, apparently the third one has a manager's license.
Well, managers are supposed to get in there. But, you know, regardless, the fans love these guys, and that's what's important, ultimately, I suppose.
We'll see how they do against this. This big team, literally and figuratively here, in Steve Rivers and Silverback.
You know, this is only one of two matches that aren't the title matches. There's 4 out of 6 for straps. So that's an amazing match.
Absolutely. And there's the bell, folks. We are on our way. Looks like that Steve Rivers starting out with, I guess we'll call him Nova 1.
He's still got his volleyball knee pads from 25 years ago that he's still using.
Yeah.
I'm surprised he's got the mayonnaise stuff on his pants.
Is Nova challenging to an arm wrestling contest?
Is that what that is?
I think that's what they're doing here.
Looks like, it doesn't matter what he looks like.
Family show.
Steve's gonna fall for this dude.
Well, if he puts his weight behind it, he's gonna win this easily. You know, being that slight 269 pounds and 1 foot. What the heck?
Is he using his foot?
He's using his foot to try to push
and
it over.
Steve just pushed all three of them. Utility-grade beef right there.
You know what, as much as I tease about the poor guy, he is a hell of an athlete. He's been in the ring with so many interesting competitors.
He's deceiving.
He's deceivingly quick, very technical.
Very technical.
And you gotta watch out for his Rivers end. His Rivers is a cross-face finisher here.
There's about a 100-pound weight difference here. He's not doing much with his arm.
In one leg. It's like, he's trying to go for an arm wringer here. And folks, I don't know what to say about that. Uh-oh, misses. Is it a foul if you use your own partner's fist in a guy's face?
I've never seen anything like this, so I don't even know.
Folks, he just used the referee to close him. There's a tag into the Silverback.
This guy's 350 pounds. Give or take 20.
Give or take. Try 200, but I got
big man. He has a hard chop. All right, he wants to go off the ropes. Yeah, no. I don't think that's going to work. Oh, it looks like he's got some extra push-ups going. Oh, he pumped himself up.
Well, that's not going to work.
Yeah, it looked like it worked so hard. Two guys trying to... No. Nope. Kick him in the gut. Oh, I got him off the ropes.
Dropped the hold. Kind
of. Sort of.
Kind of.
Got him to his knees. Oh, no. Oh, no. Could this be... This is what I don't think we want to see here.
Oh, no.
Off the ropes. Folks, we're in a loss. I'm sorry, but...
They're going to have to come up with a different strategy if they hope to do anything against 610 pounds combined.
610?
Something like that.
I thought that would be tons, but I'll pass on that. As you can see here, the silverback is just mauling Nova number two. Hooks the leg. Can this be over? Just a two.
In case you missed it, folks, the good folks here in Edmonton started a shave your back chant. I'm sure you can imagine who they're talking about.
We thought they were saying silverback. They just got misinformed.
Shave your back.
Oh,
it wasn't for the blues. Blues.
That is a running back elbow right across, sort of a drive-by style. That's got to be about 475 pounds coming right across the throat there. The referee's holding the other two. Uh-oh.
I just let the other guys go. They're going to need all three of these guys to beat these two anyway.
This seems to be more of an open and shut case for these guys, but...
Oh, he's trying to set quick snap suplex, maybe.
Best snap suplex
maybe.
In Alberta.
Maybe.
Without a doubt. Well, you've had one match in the last week.
Well, you'd have to look at some of the old things.
We'll definitely get on to Monster Pro Wrestling on YouTube. There are a lot of classic matches on there. Oh, what is this? How's this been?
Well, is that a tap up with the leg? Like, what's going on here?
That's a Rings of Saturn there. Vintage Perry Saturn on this move.
Trying to tap up.
Whoa, over 1-2. Kicks out of it. I'm impressed.
I am too.
Oh, neck breaker and a beauty. Oh, once again, Rivers gets the other two weapons in. There's no tag there. Is it bad enough? I just want them to end this already.
No.
I didn't think so. Off the ropes. Huge clothesline.
That's what you call a meat hook.
Meat sausage. There they go. One, two.
Please don't say sausage.
Looks like he's had a few kickoffs. So
he's not even put his fire in yet.
No. Got him up. Huge slam. How can you tell me sweating? It's all absorbed by the hair.
I guess.
One, two.
To be honest, I'm surprised that Rivers and Silverback haven't put these guys away already.
Yeah, I'm surprised he's kicking out the way that these weapons are right now. Tagging the Rivers. Oh, shot right to the gut.
Now, I know Rivers obviously has a set this week. I don't know a lot about Silverback. Does he have a little experience? Is he a veteran? Is he a
he's
young
a
guy?
Big shoulder block there. You have Silverback here, who is a stalwart here. One,
Rivers gets a two count there. You got Silverback, who is a stalwart in Pure Power Wrestling based out of Lethbridge. And he's gone through a ton of matches here and recently has had a bit of a change of heart. He's got him in the river's end. This version of the cross face here. It's gonna be a tough. Oh, you let him go. This dirty no good rocket son of a... Just end the damn match already. Oh no.
Well, they're trying to make a further statement.
That's what an avalanche was. There's the tag.
How's there a tag for them?
I don't think it matters at this point. We got the girl slaps. We got the girl slaps.
This is incredible.
This is something.
It's something else.
What are they trying... They got it both in headlocks. There's a tag in a third.
How is an official allowing three guys in here? Like, there's a blue battering round.
I'd say a meeting of the minds, but I think we got a little issue on that.
Yeah.
But you could see the team of the sexy American superstars is completely in control here.
Basically have the whole match.
Oh, what is... Roll the two chop. He almost had them both. Oh, looks like you got a little bit of a smack going on here.
Oh, no.
Oh! 747!
What a great match that was, folks, eh? Well, let's move into a retro match brought to you by Monster Pro Wrestling.
I had the opportunity to face a Killer Bee in Lethbridge. Now, the Killer Bee has a perfect record. Coming in here in professional wrestling, he has absolutely zero victories.
Well, at least he's consistent. I don't know what to say, folks. Since City Stranglers faced him, I haven't seen him before.
I faced him and I made him into a grease mark in the mat.
But I got a feeling his opponent coming up here, you definitely would not be able to play him a grease mark.
I've heard rumblings about this kid and I want to see it for myself.
I am the Orion, the biggest and most destructive force in MPW today. 7 feet tall, 300 pounds. I dare you to get in my way.
Now this kid is big. He's genetically gifted. There's no doubt about that. I want to see what he does. I want to see how he moves in the ring.
The biggest thing about a big guy like this, it doesn't necessarily mean just because you're jacked that you can perform in the ring.
Nope, that's true. Ask Bill Kazmaier.
Hey, you got to hand it to referee Cody here. Very smart how to check the Orion here.
Well, he's a gutsy little guy right there, I got to say, just to be in the ring with these two guys. He doesn't look like he's more than 12.
There's the bell, folks, and we're underway here.
Killer Bee trying to get the fans behind him, but...
He's going to need everything behind him, not just the fans.
Yeah, he better get the 5th Cavalry in.
5th Cavalry, he needs a swarm of bees to keep up.
Oh, here you go. Let's see.
That is a very smart move by the Killer Bee. Duck out to the outside. Use your speed in this, because I don't think the Orion is that quick.
Well, make the big guy chase you. He might tire himself out. He might have a chance then.
What the... He's asking for a free shot. Oh, he got caught. Collar and elbow. Up to the, whoa. Just shoves him up to the second rope. Referee Cody with the break. Oh, he caught him. He caught him. What's he going to do with him here? Fireman's carry. He just toyed with him here. Oh, Killer B slides through. Trying to bring him over.
Not today.
No. Whoa.
Well, I got to say, that reminded me a little bit of somebody. That reminded me a little bit of, oh, of me, yep, actually.
Couple quick shots to the leg. Trying to whip him off the ropes. It ain't going anywhere. Third try. Nope. Reversal.
Whoa.
That's got to be a size 14 right outside the face.
I think the Killer Bee's two front teeth just ended up in the front row.
I think his stinger's been ripped off here at this point. What, well, a shot.
Now, this is a perfect example of a rookie mistake. You know, go out there, toss a guy back in, get the pin, quick. One, two, three. We're not paid by the hour here.
Absolutely not. What's he trying to pull here? No, he's got him goozled. Oh my goodness! Oh my goodness! They got him in the heavens! What a choke slam! The pure power! My goodness! Strangler, your thoughts?
He certainly looks impressive in his first match, but let's face it, that was a Killer Bee. Let's see what happens when this guy gets in there against some real competition. He's got potential, no doubt.
Stay tuned for Monday Night Dynamite. Things are about to explode.
Hirsch's Auto Body. For all your auto body needs, from insurance claims to full restoration, come see the friendly staff at Hirsch's Auto Body, a proud sponsor of Monster Pro Wrestling.
Powerhouse Gym, now with two locations to serve you better, Southside and Downtown. For all your fitness needs, see Darcy at Powerhouse Gym, a proud sponsor of Monster Pro Wrestling.
The following program contains scenes of violence and mature subject matter. Viewer discretion is advised.
Tonight, now we go to our retro match. It's going to be the diabolical and evil maniac going up against the Tattoo Terminator, the number one wrestler we have in Monster Pro Wrestling, the Great Massive Damage, in a tables match. Let's see some wood break.
Monster Pro Wrestling, Riptribution 8, you have myself, the champion, Maniac, versus Massive Damage in a tables match. Now, Massive, this is my first time, but what you don't understand about me is that I always succeed the first time. So after you get put down through that table, I will get to raise this high in the air and still be the Monster Pro Wrestling Heavyweight Champion.
Riptribution 8, here we are. The show that means the most to me. Not only do we have the Ripper Royal where the fans bring the weapons, but tonight, Massive Damage gets a heavyweight title shot against Maniac. And not just any match, it's in a signature match for Massive Damage. Not a hardcore match, but a table match. I cannot wait to get my hands on you, Maniac, because when the smoke settles and the dust clears and I put you through a table, Maniac, you will realize the dream is over. And the nightmare is about to begin.
But as you can see there, referee Kevin holding the Monster Pro Wrestling Heavyweight Championship. So there are no pinfalls, no submissions in this match, but a heck of a lot of beatings, without a doubt. Oh, there's little Cody picking up the belt. This is going to be one great match, folks. This is a match where I think Maniac really wants to improve on his stature in Monster Pro Wrestling. He's always been claimed to have help with keeping that belt. Oh, and Maniac decides to take the first cheap shot here. Off the ropes. Big clothesline by Maniac. He's got to realize the clothesline's not going to be the most powerful maneuver against a guy like Massive Damage. What's behind you? Oh! That was a shot. Uh-oh, he's got the shirt over his head. He's turtling him. Oh! That chop, oh my goodness. And again, Massive Damage has one of the hardest chops in the business. Beautiful butterfly suplex there by Massive Damage. Working the shoulders and the back, as you can see on replay here. Beautiful snap to that. Got him right on his back. Awesome maneuver here. Looks like Massive Damage is in control here, but pitfalls don't really matter. Looks like Massive's going to get some toys. Yep, there it is. The first ladder of the match being introduced. And Maniac cuts him off with the pass here with the double sledge. Gets him back in the ring. I don't think Maniac wants those tables anywhere near the ring at this point. Looks like he's trying to cover him, but covers don't matter at this point. Uh-oh, Massive whips him off the ropes. Missed the clothesline. Up. Wow! Beautiful leg lariat right across the throat. Sort of like a Rough Rider type maneuver. Looks like Maniac setting up for something bigger. Oh, that beautiful drop down leg drop. So quick and sudden. Ow. Ah, there it is. Of course, there's no pitfalls here, folks, so that leg across the throat doesn't really matter at this point. What's Maniac up to now? Going up to the second rope. Big splash! I know Massive's a big body, but when you have a body like Maniac fly down at you off that second rope, that has got to be absolutely painful on those ribs. And let's face it, those ribs wear you down in a hurry. And it leads to this. Here comes the table. Doesn't look like a particularly sturdy one at this point, but hey, if it's more rickety, the more chance a person's going to go through it. Oh! Oh my God, you can see the bruising on Maniac's chest already. Beautiful European uppercut. Oh! Massive went to forearm chop. Maniac, and he missed and hit his hand right on that table. Might have bruised or even broke a finger there. Looks like Maniac's trying to send him through the table the long way. Massive just doesn't look like he's ready yet for it. Go to the corner. Oh, he just missed! Oh, and a big boot by Maniac coming in. On Maniac coming in. Fall by him. Jumping clothesline by Massive Damage there. Definitely a hard-hitting affair here, folks. As you just saw the replay there with that hard clothesline. Looks like Massive setting up for that spear. Spear's patented maneuver. That'll put him right through the table. Break him right in half. Ah, oh, and I imagine it's a sneak out of the way here. Ah, he's pointing at his head, and I do agree with him. That is quite a smart move to sneak out to the outside here. But it looks like Bassett's going to look for something else right now. What else could he be looking for? Another table? You already got one in the ring. What do you need a second one for? Once again, Mania catching him off of the pass here. What's going on here? Oh, hard forearm shot to the back. Is he going to set that table up right on the outside? This sounds like trouble for massive damage. Looks like he's going for a suplex. Nope, blocked. Blocked again. Oh, staff suplex by massive damage. You just heard the splat there. Let's take a look at the replay. Oh, just quickly whips him over there. Ow! The front of Maniac's chest is red, and the back might be black and blue at this point. Referee Kevin checking up both competitors. There isn't much he can really do. This match won't be over until he actually somebody actually gets put through a table. I don't know, Maniac might actually be wanting to go through a table at this point. As his head gets rammed into that table on the outside. Massive looks like he's in full control here. And Maniac, the smart man, gotta give him credit for it. Turns the table over on his side. He can't be put through it if, What a chair shot by massive damage. There's no disqualifications in the match, folks, so a chair is as legal as a headlock. Looks like Massive's just trying to figure out how he wants to put Maniac through this table here and get that Monster Pro Wrestling Heavyweight Championship. Looks like he's following the crowd. Played the crowd a little bit too much. I don't know if that's going to make him successful here or not. Fans are calling for the gore. Going in. Nope. Missed again. But Ike is quick for a big man. Well, I would say if I had the fear of God and somebody trying to put me through a table, I'd be quick too, so. Oh! Ow! I don't know what else to say there, folks. Just ow. You know what chops hard when it literally takes you off your feet? But Ike looks in so much pain right now. It doesn't even look like he needs face paint on his chest. He is bright red regardless. Ripped off the ropes. Uh-oh, what's going on here? No way. Pile driver! That's got to be more out of desperation as he picks him up and spikes him right on his head with that pile driver there. That's definitely changed the fortunes of this match here. Now, but I going over to that table. Setting it up. I don't know what he's trying to do here. He's got it set up on the corner of the ring there. Now moving it over to the center. Looks like he's got bad intentions here. I didn't want to say it, you can. It's going to be hard for Maniac to get him up and onto that table there, so. Now he's got him on the table, but he's got to go through the table in order to be victorious here. Looks like Maniac's head to the top. Calling for it, saying that's over. Oh, Massive's up. Oh, crotched on the top and the little maniacs. Oh, what's going on here? Looks like somebody hit the power switch to the lights here. Looks like Massive's trying to set him up to put him through that table with a superplex here. Hey, wait a second. What? Sydney Steele, Chris Parrish. You got the One World Empire in the ring. Oh, they moved the table out of the way. Big superplex, but no table. Let's take a look at that again. Yeah, those two shysters. Move that table out of the way. Now they're just laying the boots to Massive Damage. You knew that Madai couldn't handle this on his own. What's going on here? Double suplex? Try to get him up. Massive's holding down. Look out! Beautiful! Wow! Let's take a look at that replay here. Snaps him over with that suplex up both Sydney Steele and Chris Parrish. Well, this one-on-one has turned into a three-on-one now, folks. Massive's got to go through a lot to get through this here. Uh-oh. Looks like he's got Maniac all set up for it. Coming across that spear. Missed! Setting up for a belly to back. Blocked by Massive. Oh, come on. One World Empire there. Oh, referee Kevin kicks him out of the way. Uh-oh. But I got a low blow in there. Fireman's carry. Dead belly driver into the table, but the table did not break. Oh, my goodness. The table did not break there. Maniac should have won this match, but without the table breaking, this match continues. What's Maniac going to do now? Looks like Sydney Steele's trying to set that table up again. He's got him up once again. A second Death Valley driver. A piece of that table broke, but it didn't break all the way through. Massive still in it, but I think he's out of it. This is unbelievable, folks. That table just will not break. I think Massive might have some Zen powers over the ability of these tables here. So what are they going to do now? They've set it up again. No way. Billy to back suplex through the table. Not through the table, onto the table. The table will not give. Massive's got to have a concussion right now. He's completely out of it. That table just will not break. I don't know what they're going to do to win this match. It's bad enough, but I can't win this on his own. He needs his two buddies down at ringside here. The fans are cheering for the table. Hey, what's going on here? That scream sounds familiar. Wait, what are these guys doing? Setting up the table in the middle of the ring. I don't know if that table's going to hold now. The brace seems to be gone. But what's going on here? No way. No way. No. It can't be. No. Ah, damn it. Triple powerbomb through the table. And Maniac steals another one. Absolute robbery here at Riptribution as we go through the replays here. Beautiful butterfly suplex. And then there is a leg lariat by Maniac. Then Maniac took, this is the move that he took control with, that pile driver. But here's where the whole match changed completely. Massa was about to put Madayak through the table with the superplex, and the One World Empire comes in and breaks it up. And this is how it ends, folks. The triple powerbomb through the table. Your winner and still Monster Pro Wrestling Heavyweight Champion, Madayak. I would really like to see if this guy could actually win a match one-on-one. He looks so happy right now. He looks borderline crazy, not just happy. Yeah, another victory for the One World Empire here. But a gallant effort by Massive Damage here at Retribution 8 in his attempt to win that heavyweight championship. We got some great Monster Pro Wrestling action coming up, so stay tuned.
Hirsch's Auto Body. For all your auto body needs, from insurance claims to full restoration, come see the friendly staff at Hirsch's Auto Body, a proud sponsor of Monster Pro Wrestling.
Powerhouse Gym. Now with two locations to serve you better, Southside and Downtown. For all your fitness needs, see Darcy at Powerhouse Gym, a proud sponsor of Monster Pro Wrestling.
The following program contains scenes of violence and mature subject matter. Viewer discretion is advised.
Now we move on to the main event of their evening here on Monday Night Dynamite, featuring a four-way tag title match. In one corner, we're gonna have the high-flying Hellraisers. In another corner, the sexy American superstars are back with a thirst for vengeance, going up against a third team, The Struggle, which apparently is real. And finally, the fourth team consisting of the Wild Child, Tyler James, and the real deal, Sydney Steele, Alpha and Omega. Let's get to the action, folks.
What's up, Monster Pro Wrestling fans? Tonight at the Alberta Avenue Hall for Retribution, you get to see Diablo and Kid Cyrus in a fatal four-way tag match for the championship. We got the Sexy Americans, we got Sydney Steele and Tyler James, we got the high-flying Hellraisers, who if we have, of course, the champions, The Struggle. Well, guess what? We're gonna come out on top.
Me and Diablo here are gonna give it everything we got to take the new tag team championships. Tonight's a wonderful night.
It is!
Because The Struggle are your tag team champions.
Yeah!
And we're so good that we have to defend against three other teams. You got the, Hell-Raising High Flyer? What are they called?
The High-Flying Hellraisers.
It doesn't matter. We've beaten you so many times. We forget who you are sometimes. We got the Sexy American Superstars.
They're sassy!
They're not sexy at all.
No.
No, not at all. And then we got the Alpha and Omega.
They are firm, fresh eggs!
Between the two of them, I don't know who's the Alpha and who's the Omega.
They're both of them.
But that's besides the point, because tonight is Retribution, and tonight is The Struggle's night, and tonight is the night The Struggle retain our titles.
Because we are real!
And we are spectacular!
Four-way tag title match for the championship. You know what? A lot of people think we're at a disadvantage, Bradley, but you know what? We're not, because that's three other teams that we get to put a beating on. Tell them.
Squash them. That's the game plan. All we're gonna do is come in there and kick ass.
Those belts are ours. You might as well just walk in and hand them over now. Save yourselves the beating.
Tonight, the Wild Child, Tyler James, and the real deal, Sydney Steele, we're going to take the tag team championships to the extreme, brother. Tell them, Steele. We're in the ring with three other teams. The Sexy American Superstars, The Struggle, and the High-Flying Hellraisers. There is not a chance that any of those three can beat either of us. So tonight, when all is said and done, you're looking at your new MPW tag team champions.
Good luck, referee Brad Chatterley gets up. Here we go.
Everybody.
Everybody.
It's kindergarten class. They learn how to count.
I will say this. The only thing I can't figure out Why doesn't the referee count the Oh! A little malfunction at the junction!
I don't know, Mike, there's a reason they call you ref. Why can't you count to 10?
Oh! I'm trying to knock Bradley Graham off his feet. He ain't going nowhere! The big man's rocked! The big man's rocked! Can we get him down?
It took four regular sized men to do it. I hope you don't go out there.
Referee hasn't cleaned everybody out yet. Uh-oh. We got Cyrus up at the top rope.
What's he got in mind? There's nobody to jump on.
Uh-oh. Graham back up to his feet. Oh, he got caught. Ref of the splash got caught.
That wasn't too smart.
Oh, big slam there.
Oh, boy. Get that kid the MRI. This is over.
Now, folks, the rules of this match, teams can tag in anybody outside. You cannot pin a member of your same team, but the first person to gain a fall will win it for his team and win the MPW Tag Team Championship.
Oh, he's just smashing Kid Cyrus off that mat.
Well, look at the weight difference here. It's got to be somewhere around 900 pounds difference here.
This is unbelievable.
There's the tag into Steve Rivers, the 25-year vet. And you know, one of the few Triple Crown winners in MPW.
And rightfully so.
Oh, snap suplex.
He suplexed that kid right out of his boots. Drop it in the
knee right to the forehead. Got him to cover. One, two. Just a two count.
Every time there's a title on the match and there's two or three competitors or three or four teams, I gotta tell you, I'm strongly opposed to it because the champions do not gotta be involved in the pinfall.
Like right here, one, two. Just a two count here.
And they always said, it's a popular phrase in order to be the man, you gotta beat the man.
What a smart move by Maniac there. Blind tag on to Steve Rivers. Now he's in, now Maniac's in the match and the struggle's in charge here. Oh, there's the tag in. Diablo, can he be dialing it up? Six. Off the top springboard. Splash, coming one, two. I thought for sure we're going to have new champs there.
It was close, but you know what? Maniac is tough as nails, man. He is tough.
Oh! Takes him over the top! Oh, there was a blind tag there to Sidney Steele.
No love
lost.
Very
smart move.
There we go. Now the struggle is in control. See that? You see what I'm talking about? You got to hit him. Hit him!
Once again, the struggle, isolating. Uh-oh. Oh, I haven't seen that before. They're shooting a side slam. One, two.
That'll break a lot of y'all at once.
Very unique finishing move there.
I want to see Bradley Graham in this match. I want to see what the big man can do.
Well, if the struggle, uh-oh, could it be? They're setting up for it. It's help! Help!
I don't know if they have a room for that.
Two and a half. Oh, shot. What is Steele doing here? Trying to fight his way back up.
I don't know, but I think he's got that.
Oh, missed that. Double clothesline. And I think I just saw a tooth go flying.
I think Sidney Steele's got a couple of big marks on his face. I think he took some serious shots.
Absolutely. And referee Ben's indicating there's no count out here. So we just got to get somebody back up, somebody to a corner. There's the tag. Wild tag. Tyler James is in. European uppercut.
You know I beat that guy too, right?
Oh, what a Uranagi slam! Cover, one, two!
And a kick out! The title, Maniac's tough, man. man. He's hard to beat. You got to really work him before you can count on him. Oh!
What a jawjacker! Pierced over the cover. One, two. Just a two. So close. What's he doing with Rivers here? DDT! Spiked him right on his head. Rolls him over. Hooks the leg. Two.
That
no.
Out. Bradley Graham's going to even up the score here. At all.
Oh! Oh! Super kick!
He just ate a super kick!
One, two, oh, two!
Goodness!
Tiny Jay's throwing out the heavy artillery here! Tag team titles on the line!
Oh, he's taking too long. This is going to backfire. Ah, there we go!
On the next go! He went three quarters of the way across the ring.
Nia just threw him a distance.
Oh, a knee right to the face. It's over. One, two, oh. Oh! Diablo had enough and came in with that splash. Sling blade by Sarris.
There's a lot of action going on here, bro. Diablo, a lot of action.
Breaks it up. And what's Paris doing? These guys are fighting outside.
We got Bradley Graham in front of us with TJ. Oh, here comes Mania. They're setting up for...
Oh, no. Could this be? No way. They got on top. No. We got James and Graham and Manaic on the outside. Rivers.
Oh, oh, five.
Super kick. My God.
Look at all the action. That guy's out here fighting me. That guy's in there fighting. I'll bet you they're in the parking lot fighting right now. I can't sit still.
I can't keep track here, folks. This is breaking down.
Oh, my goodness.
But in the ring, we got Pierce and the High Flying Hellraisers. That's who's left.
Now out of the ring, we got everybody.
What is Cyrus doing?
Don't do this. Medication. I'm gonna pop over here. This is insane. The fans are going bananas.
There's no count out. There's no DQ.
Okay, now the struggle's getting back into the ring. They gotta win their titles back. I mean, this is a hell of a fight, but oh my goodness. Okay, Sidney Steele.
Well, they gotta get somebody in the ring to go with them. Or else they're never gonna. They're not going to get pinfall on anybody.
I can't believe it. What I'm seeing, I mean, we still got guys laying on the floor out here. We got nobody's in their seats. The struggles in the ring trying to set something. Here comes Sidney Steele. Sidney. Well, it's impossible to call, Mike. This is impossible to call.
Well, we got James finally back in the ring. Got him from behind. Meeting of the minds.
No!
Oh, both of them dumped over the top rope.
Sidney Steele, he's setting up for the...
Oh! Get to the minds! Yes! Yep. Oh, my God!
This game's of justice!
was awesome! This is wrong!
Ladies and gentlemen, your winners of this match and new Monster Pro Wrestling Tag Team Champions, the Alpha Omega!
Oh, the Alpha Omega finishing there! A super kick into the German suplex!
This place is erupting, and we've only made it through our third match! I don't know if this building is going to contain the rest of this night, but with our new MPW Tag Champions, and I'll tell you what, I'll write out a protest myself, because those guys didn't pin the champions.
I'm sure Chris Harris and Maniac are gonna have their own way with that one.
If they don't get a rematch next month and they don't regain their titles, I don't know what I'm gonna do, but it's gonna be impolite and it's gonna probably contain a few vulgar words.
As you see, the new MPW Tag Team Champions, Tyler James, Sidney Steele, the Alpha and Omega.
You know I beat both of those guys, right?
March 4th, Ranch Roadhouse Adult Show.
Well, 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 Angelica. I told you I was going to beat you, and that's exactly what I did.
I'd like to congratulate you, sexy Samantha. You got one over on me. It's clear you've got the brains. But everyone knows that Angelica has the beauty.
Well, you know what? Bring it. I don't mind. March 4th, at the ranch, it's called Roadhouse. Be there.
The Tattooed Terminator, Massive Damage, brings the Ripper title, the hardcore title, with him. And do I have an opponent? Oh boy, do I. Bulldog McBain. The storied past we've had, pal. From you beating us for our tag team titles in the National Tag Team Title Tournament, to you trying to end my career. When you bust open my eye, I have not forgot. So Bulldog McBain, March 4th at the Ranch Adult Show. This hardcore title on the line. There's no rules for you. There's no rules for me. But I have a little message for you, pal. Massive Damage is coming. The dream is over and the nightmare is about to begin.
Hirsch's Auto Body. For all your auto body needs, from insurance claims to full restoration, come see the friendly staff at Hirsch's Auto Body, a proud sponsor of Monster Pro Wrestling.
Powerhouse Gym. Now with two locations to serve you better, Southside and Downtown. For all your fitness needs, see Darcy at Powerhouse Gym, a proud sponsor of Monster Pro Wrestling.
Ever had thoughts of becoming a wrestler? Dreams of being a part of the squared circle? Whether you're male or female, check out the Monster Pro Wrestling Training Center, located at Gold's Gym Westmount in Edmonton. Two 20-foot rings. But enough of me talking about it. Let's talk to the promoter, Massive Damage.
All right, we're here with Massive Damage at the Monster Pro Wrestling Factory, the training facility here.
Factory.
how long has the factory been around for, Massive?
Well, Monster Pro Wrestling has been training people since, I want to say, 2002. I think we had our first ring set up in a building, and we have evolved to having two rings set up at Gold's Gym in Westmount Mall, which you can't really ask for a better place. You got weights and cardio equipment and showers and two professional wrestling rings up. You got myself, Canadian Hall of Fame wrestler. You got Phil LaFon, who's a legend in Japan, former WWE and ECW alumni. We got heavyweight champion, the Irishman today, guest training, doing a little bit of work with the ladies division today. I've been working kind of with the fellas today. We've got a lot lot of new students, and it's exciting. So if you want to get a hold of some training, we're going to have a website and a number at the bottom of the screen. Get a hold of me, and this could be your future.
There you have it, folks. If you want to make a dream come true, stop by the Monster Pro Wrestling Training Center in Westmount Mall at Gold's Gym and get trained by the best. Monster Pro Wrestling Training Academy, training futures with pro wrestling the way it should be.